Yeah, so we are here, day of the show. Pretty surreal moment to be here in Toronto in this amazing, obviously, space, Airbnb, and to know this one moment is accumulation of all of the work over the last, not just 4 to 6 months of dieting down, but you know, the off seasons, but also lifting since I was 12 years old. I think it's just a testament to obviously everything we put ourselves through as athletes to get to this moment. And sometimes I think that we kind of brush by it because we're so ready to get to the end of it, get to the result. But I think that it's so important to slow down and enjoy the moment and just understand that this is what you've been working for the last, you know, not just 6 months, but years, 5 years, 10 years. And this is the big one. This is the pro card moment. So this is the last show of the year for me. It's kind of my last shot at it. Not to say we've taken a shot at it, but first and last. So whether that's confident or cocky, who knows? But I'm definitely excited for the experience and more so than anything, just appreciative of just this whole week being here with Calum and you behind the lens, just fucking crushing it, but also just being overly supportive. And I just feel like we've already built this like really great camaraderie with each other. And I mean, I already feel like definitely some lifelong friendships are brewing here, and then also business partnerships. So it's just one of those things that bodybuilding brings people together. And it is such an immense community of people that are like-minded, want to see the best for one another, and obviously are striving towards just like just being that 1% better every day, which I think just spills over to business, personal life, and also just the ability to be relatable with people who are struggling or kind of pushing themselves in anything in life. So yeah, I'm just really grateful for the moment. So we're about to go get second coat of tan, which I'm about to get all crispy and orange now. Yeah, it's gonna be a fun day. I feel really good about what we brought to the table this morning, and we're just gonna continue to fill out one more meal to go, and then we're on the stage. So basically wish me luck at this point, because it's either we did the work or somebody worked a little harder than us, so, or they were looking for something a little different. So yeah, it's gonna be a fun day, and I'm excited for, you know, whatever it holds, win, loss, it's all gonna be a win for me, just because I came in the best I ever have today, for sure.
toes. Front relax. Quarter ton. Yeah, there it is. Beautiful. Quarter ton. Toes. Yeah, get that quad off. There you go.
Excuse me?
Relaxed. Yeah. Right on bicep. So yeah, there you go.
Perfect.
Good.
9:30.
Got an hour. Go get you backstage, get your feet up, before we start pumping up, sure. The awards in attendance.
Yeah.
registered. Competitor number 60, Stanislav Mazur. In third place, competitor number 59, Nicholas McLeod. In second place, number 57, Jesse Goudet. And your winner, number 58, Eric Janicki. All right, gentlemen, let's get those hands high up in the air for our cameras. All right, just the athletes now. And just the winner now. All right, thank you. Equipment development and nutritional supplement industry. Please visit them at yourbarbell.com. And we'll head over to our head judge for the comparison round. Quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right. Quarter turn to the right. Face front. Front double bicep. Side chest. Back double bicep. Relax. Be a little pose down music.
T-O-N-E.
T-O-N-E.
So if you were looking it up.
Eric found this, apparently is one of the highest rated sushi places in Toronto. So far it has lived up to their reputation. It's quite a monumental day for Magic Eye behind the camera, because not only is he 40, but he's never had sushi in the 40 years he's been alive. So I'm going to take the camera now, and we're going to have a little review of what's happened. So Jay, just talk me through what you thought of the sushi so far.
It's been great, mate.
What's been your favourite one?
The chicken and beef.
The chicken and beef. We got them sushi rolls with chicken and beef and chicken teriyaki. And look at this one. This one has beef on top of it.
It is good though.
Beef on top, avocado in the middle. Literally no fish whatsoever.
It's bodybuilding, isn't it? It's like,
yeah. Hit it, bro.
Yeah, it's
the thing I do like about it is that there's no seaweed in these ones, because you can't see.
He's gone, I'm not too keen on the seaweed, to be honest. And I was like, you do realise there's seaweed in all of them. You just can't see it.
You can't see it. It's like training back. If you can't see it, you can't feel it.
You can't see the weed.
Right. So as a reward for eating sushi for the first time, I'm going to give you the sushi tiara.
Thank you, bro.
And you just put that on.
Toss it on, please.
There you go.
It was what I made for you.
Really good.
No, you have to keep that on for the rest of the meal.
It's romantic.
Right?
Oh, shit. Let's go.
You take me for sushi, I take you for dessert. That's how it goes, isn't it?
Oh. Oh my god. That's true, my friend. That was true.
You warm?
Don't have one, dude. Before they get cold.
Nah, yours will.
I've never actually had one before.
Never had a churro?
No.
What the fuck's going on around here? Jesus!
I'm out of churro.
Thank God. Can I get a bite of your cheese steak before it's done?
It's actually filled inside as well, Jesus Christ. It's way gooier than the last one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's good.
Is that good?
Right, guys, this is a wrap for Toronto. This has been an absolutely epic weekend. The result wasn't the icing on the cake. We didn't get the overall, we didn't get the card, he got a class win, but the more time you spend doing this, the more time you realize that that's part of the process, and that bittersweet moment is the part that really materializes into that final defining moment where it happens. So I've got no doubt that we'll do that. The game plan for Eric at the moment is to just push back into an off-season. I think from a review perspective yesterday, we'll probably do a little bit of the airport, but from a review perspective yesterday, I think upper body wise he's very complete, lower body wise we got exposed. The guy who won the overall in class B was much, much shorter, but a lot more dense, a lot more compact. He was very, very good, so if it was going to go to someone, I was happy it went to him because he was a very good athlete. But off season for Eric, he's got about 20 pounds to play with for his cap, so he's got a lot of weight he can put on, and the majority of that is probably going to go to his legs because his upper body is already very complete. But you know, weekends like this I absolutely love because it's just an experience. It's experiencing a new culture, it's an experience in a new city. It's cool to have Magic Eye with me as well. And just kind of getting those moments together. It's first sushi last night. All the first this weekend.
Proper virginity, bro.
Pure muscle and fitness has been epic as well. It's just been a really, really cool weekend. So until next time, thank you for watching, guys. And we'll see you soon.